Let's talk about tokens. So you may have come across the idea of tokens when it comes to ChatGPT. So this lesson is all about diving in and exploring what is a token. Essentially, ChatGPT has a token limit. So ChatGPT-3 has a limit of 4,096 tokens, and ChatGPT-4 has a limit of around 8,000 tokens. What that means is that if you wrote a prompt for ChatGPT-3 that used 4,000 tokens, that would only leave 96 tokens available for the response. Because yes, your input, the prompt that you put into ChatGPT and ChatGPT's response both count towards the token maximum. So what is a token? A token is about 4 English characters, or about 3/4 of a word. You can think of it as 1 to 2 sentences being 30 tokens, paragraph being 100 tokens, and 1,500 words being about 2,048 tokens, meaning this is about half of ChatGPT-3's token maximum. I'll link this page in the resources so you can go ahead and read all these amazing examples. It goes on to explain you miss 100% of the shots you don't take, contains 11 tokens, talks about token limits, pricing, exploring tokens, and we will dive into the tokenizer as well. What's interesting about this section here is that it explains that the same word in different contexts will create a different token. So for example, a lowercase red here in the middle of a sentence is a different token from an uppercase red in the same placement of the sentence, which is again a different token than a uppercase red starting at the beginning of a sentence. But if you'll look here at the bottom, each word corresponds to its token. So here the period is token number 13, and here the period is token number 13. This is because periods are often used in the same context. So ChatGPT is always able to understand the context of this period in all of these three sentences and giving it the same token value. It's my experience when you get close to exceeding the amount of tokens, ChatGPT's response starts getting less accurate and a little more nonsensical and less reliable. So there are a few tactics you can keep in mind to make sure that you're getting the maximum response out of ChatGPT, even if you're pushing up to the token limit. Not only does your input, the prompt you put into ChatGPT, count against the token limit, also ChatGPT's answer counts against the token limit, and ChatGPT uses the previous information in your chat to count against the token limit as well. What this means is if you've been having a long discussion about Paris or about France, and ChatGPT is able to remember your previous conversations, it's able to remember what we were talking about before. That's because in a long conversation, it will take in your prompt, it'll have its answer, and then whatever is left over in the token limit, it will look back that amount. And so it'll take in that specific amount of information that it can recall. So if you have a super long conversation, ChatGPT will no longer remember the top of the conversation because it will exceed the token maximum. So what you can do about that is if you have a really long conversation, you can ask ChatGPT to summarize the conversation from there on. And then you can either copy that and start it in a new chat or just keep going from there. But that way, when ChatGPT needs to look back to see what the context is, it can see that summary and understand, oh, okay, this is what we were talking about before, and you won't get some incomplete or nonsensical answers because the main point of context was maybe at the start of the conversation and it's been so long that ChatGPT can no longer find the start of the conversation. So asking it to summarize the conversation in the middle of a long conversation is a quick hack for allowing yourself to not run into issues with the token maximum. If you're curious about how many tokens your prompt is going to take or some input data is going to take, we can jump over to the tokenizer so you can give it a test and it'll tell you exactly how many tokens a piece of text is going to take. Again, I want to stress that ChatGPT 3.5 has a limit of 4,096 tokens, while the ChatGPT 4 model has a limit of just above 8,000 tokens. Now here we're in the tokenizer, and what we're able to do here is see how many tokens a sentence will take. How many tokens will this take? Uses 7 tokens and 31 characters. This is a helpful rule of thumb. Let's just copy this text at the bottom and see how many tokens this takes. This takes 89 tokens. So if you're ever curious about how many tokens something is going to take, you can load up the tokenizer, paste your text in here, and it will give you an answer. It's not so important to know the exact number of tokens in a given model. The general framework is that there is a limit for how much input and output there can be. And if you're running into issues, like you're running into the maximum limit and ChatGPT is giving you really truncated, short, maybe even nonsensical answers, it's because you're running into that limit. So one thing you can do is start a new chat so that you are not referencing the information of the past, which is taking up your token limit.